Hello, this is Dimitri with Ugears US, UKids LLC. We're going to be doing a new model today, which is a Dream Cabrio VM-05. This was just recently released about a little bit less than a month ago. I'm going to try to keep up with the new models and then come back to the older ones that I haven't done. So this is going to be one of the new ones that I'm going to do. Should take a little bit of time, and there's 735 parts to it, so it might take some time for us. Normally for these larger models it took me about 6 hours, so we'll see how long this one's going to take. So let's go ahead and open it up. See what we have inside the box. So as always, all the papers are wrapped, and inside the actual box we have some thin smaller rubber bands, we have two thicker ones, a piece of wax. If you don't find that, occasionally they forget to put it, and I actually prefer usage of the regular candle wax or tea candle wax, and these little tin cups. It's a little bit softer. That one might be a little bit easier to apply, especially to the gears. This one I usually just dip the gears inside there. Have a set of toothpicks. Once again, if you don't have that, occasionally they do manufacture a lot, so if they forget to put one, just regular toothpicks that you can get at any grocery store, 2-point toothpicks. Just this, not sure what is that going to be used for, and we have a little bit of piece of sandpaper. So I'm going to put this aside, and we're going to go ahead and open up the boards. So just a little slice with my X-Acto knife, and we'll pull the manual out first. As always, I'm going to go through the instructions in the manual. See what's in there. So the boards are usually in numerical order, starting from 1 through 8. I'm gonna put these aside also, as we don't need them at this time. And it is a pretty thick manual, so let's start from the beginning. One thing they have started to add into the manual, just to show you what spare parts we have. So this is a nice addition to it, in my opinion. That way you guys know if you break something, you know if you need to contact us or not, or if you can just go and find it on the board. So if it has a little bit add symbol to it, usually add plus sign, that means it's a spare part, so you can use it for the assembly. So as you can see, there's some number 12s, number 61, 17, 74, 57, and 285, 286. So if any of those parts break during the assembly, just pull it off the board. If you use that one up also, as always, you can contact me at info@ugears.us for the US customers. If you purchased it from me or one of my affiliates, meaning from the stores that I sell to, I will replace those at no charge. However, if you purchased it elsewhere, I can either order it from the manufacturer directly, which normally takes about 3 to 4 weeks, or for a small shipping fee, usually it's $3.50, I can ship it out to you out of my US warehouse. Once again, unfortunately I cannot cover the shipping cost if you purchased it elsewhere, but if you did purchase it from me, I'll gladly do that for you. Going to the next page, which is number 3. So there is this tool. I have one from previous assembly that I did. So it's a little kind of like a rocket looking thing. There's 3 different sizes. They're possibly different sizes on the one for this Cabrio. A little bit measurement device. This is for the rubber bands, very helpful. Just whatever size you need to get. And then this pointy face is to push the parts out, if the ones that are hard to get with your fingers. There's a little hole that's for the toothpicks. It'll help you to push them through if you're having trouble. You can just, I'll show you right away, so you don't have to look for it further down. So when you put a toothpick in, you can kind of insert it here, and then you push it into the part with the tool, which makes it easier, and you don't damage your fingers or poke your fingers through. So this is a helper tool. We'll find it on the board. Let's see. And I would assume it'll be on the first one, but it might be somewhere else. I'm sure they're gonna point it out where it's at once we get to it in the manual. So it is on board number 3 on the bottom, a little bit left to the of the center line. So I can just pull it out right now. So I have it. Just make sure that we don't forget about it. So nice little tool here. I'll put boards back together. Clean it off of the excess material. So we have the tool. I'm gonna put it aside. I'm gonna go through the symbol. So when you see the symbol with the toothpick and the gear, that means you use the candle wax. Once again, tea candle or wax that is provided inside the box. If you see exclamation point, you need to pay attention to what's specified in the instructions. If you put it in correctly, it's not gonna work. A little fan blowing with the arrows, freely moving assembly, obviously. Mirror, self-explanatory, has to be a mirror image. Symmetry, same thing, have to be symmetrical around the center line. This just points out to where to use the sandpaper or a file, which I prefer in a lot of cases over the sandpaper, but sandpaper works just fine. And then obviously to use the knife, X-Acto knife, scalpel knife, toolbox cutter, whichever knife you prefer to use. Regular toothpicks, don't pay attention. I mean, it is a general size, plus minus a little bit, some tolerances in it, but it is a regular toothpick that you can get at any grocery store, as I mentioned before. And here's the some rubber band sizes that we're gonna be using during the assembly. These are also kind of easy to do. Just take a rubber band, wrap it around your finger, take one end and put it through the loop that you just created and tie it up. So when you get to the specific size, you move that loop along the side of the along the rubber band, and once you get it to the point where you need it, then you tie it up. And then you just keep on remeasuring if you need to move it a little bit. It doesn't have to be exactly, like in this case, like 23 millimeters or whatnot, but close enough. Then you tie it as much as you can, and then you use your X-Acto knife to slice it off. I will go through that in the assembly again, but here we have one of the longer ones ready at 23 millimeters. I think that covers the instructions a little bit. So I'm gonna put everything inside and I'm gonna go ahead and start on the assembly. Let's see, we're all good and recording here. So obviously starting up with board number 1, I'm gonna flip the boards over and let's go. So for the first step, we need part number 1, 2, and 3. Number 2 is top right side. Number 1 is right below it. Once again, some parts are fragile. You might want to use the box cutter to push out, or you need to apply the pressure at the connection points, and I usually do it from front to back. That way you don't damage the part. If the fiber is getting pulled, you pull it from the board rather than from the part. And then number 3 should be right at the center line towards the bottom here, below the middle. So we got these 3 parts. We need to pay attention to the teeth. Wax a little bit part number 3. There's no connection points on the outside diameter, so you just apply a little bit of wax on it. Then you need to make sure that part number 2 teeth are facing clockwise direction, not counterclockwise. You insert the part number 1 from the back. as far as it can go, snapping it all together, and then insert part number 3. So there's like a little double notch towards the top. Well, I mean, it wouldn't matter at the end of the day, but make sure that your teeth are facing clockwise direction. So as you insert it, just push it all the way in to the surface of part number 2. If it goes a little bit hard, either you can put wax on here on the sides, or you can send it down a little bit. So now we need to put a little bit sandpaper on that side of the gear. Part number 4, which is also on board number 1, and that's to the left of the center line all the way at the top. So we face it with that circular boss down towards the bottom, and that up round towards the right. And then you insert part number the assembly that we did from the back into that center bigger circle that you have. I would sand both faces. Just looks like there's going to be some connection there. And on top of it, I would put a little bit of a wax. So in this case, I guess this stick wax would be a little bit better. Easier to do. And then just apply a little bit of wax on the outside of that surface, because there's going to be gears moving around it, and then you push that sub-assembly through that big circle. Number 3 gets close to it. So I guess you don't need to push that part number 1 all the way in, just for it to engage. So you need to make sure that these little parts or side things don't stick out, because you do need to insert it through. That part number 3 needs to sit inside that little circle. And then we need part number 5, which is also on the board number 1 to the left, and you need to put a wax. As I said, for me it's easier just to use the tea candle wax that you can just stick the gear in, and it's all nice and waxed. And then you put it through all the way to the surface of part number 4. Now we need 2 number 7s for step number 3 and part number 6. Those are all on part number 6. One is to the left here. There's 4 of them, or total 8. So they're going to be all used through the assembly. So make sure you don't lose them. I'll pull the whole square out, take one out and put it on the side, so you, once again, you don't lose them. And then that, make sure it's nice and clean, and put anything cylindrical that might go inside opening, I would wax. I chose to wax it here, so we're doing it right. And then number 7s are right next to that little square. There's 2 little pieces. Once again, you can use the tool to help you out a little bit, or your finger if you're okay pushing it out. And those 2 things go, there's 2 2 square openings. So you just insert it in there. With the slot is in a horizontal plane, so just like this. And part number 6, we waxed it, goes over to lock the gear, and it goes all the way to the end. So we're done with the at the end. Now we need to go into the bottom portion of this page. Here we need the tool that was on board number 3, which shows right here. And we use a toothpick, cut it in half, take one side, we insert it in Z2Z, and make a specific length little small little piece. Then we need part number 8, which is also on board number 1 towards the top here on the right hand side. There's my tool, push it out. And then we insert the toothpick in one of the holes. And needs to be symmetrical around the center line, so sticking out about the same distance on both sides. And step number 2, it goes through part number 9, and then we need another 6. So part number 9 is all the way on the right top almost. And then part number 6 is right there. And once again, I put a little bit of wax on there. And then with a little ball sticking towards the bottom, hook on the right, we push the part number 8 from the back, and the hole is in the horizontal direction all the way to the end, and then we put part number 6 over that part number 8. These little notches are also in a horizontal direction, and that completes our step number 2. Now we need step number 3, rubber band. I used one up, smaller one, whichever. Once again, you loop it around, push the rubber band, push one end through the loop that you just created, and tie it up. As you move the knot on the rubber band, just to get it as close as possible to about 8 millimeters, and then tie it, slice off the excess, and push it through the little hook that we have on the right hand side. And that completes step number 3. Moving on to page number 5, put that one aside. Here we need part number 10, also on board number 1, all the way on the right here. We can might as well just push part number 13 also, which is right next to it. Then we need part number 12, that's out in the top here, two circular ones. And part number 11, which is right next to the same cluster here. Alrighty, let's see, so another part of the toothpick with our tool on 2Z. That one goes through part number 10, one of the holes. Same thing as on the previous one, symmetrical, so it sticks out on both sides. And then that goes through, in step number 2, goes through the center hole here with a hook facing towards the left, and you insert the part from the back. The hole should be in a vertical, or hole axis is in a vertical direction. Just insert it all the way in, and then part number 12 goes over it. Don't forget to wax part number 12 because it's probably going to go into one of the holes. And that with the notches also in a vertical direction, you insert it all the way to the end. And then part number 13, it goes into the slot right next to it on the right hand side with a slot in a horizontal direction. Now we need another rubber band, same size. Are slippery after the candle wax, but we still managed to do it. Alrighty. So these little drawings are to scale, so you're safe to measure against it. Mine is a little bigger, but just a little tiny bit, which is okay. If you want, you can remake it. And I could do it just to show that you just need to make sure that you cut in between first and the second loop that you made. My loop came out a little bit too big or not, so I'll make it on the other side. A little bit, which one's over it? Take the smaller of the two, and same thing, push it as in a previous page through that loop or hook, and stick out on the right. Okay. Then we'll take that assembly all the way from the beginning. Make sure that long stick facing you. We put the assembly that we just made on the left-hand side here. So the one with the number 12 goes through that hole on the left. And then the larger piece goes through the opening there, just like this. And then the other sub-assembly that we just created with the hook toward to the right, it goes through the top hole just like that. So they're going to be interlocking on the right hand side. Now we need parts number 14, 6, 15 and 12. So 12 is all the way at the top. 6 we have here. Number 15 and 14 are on the bottom here. So all of them need to be lubricated all around on the outside. Right, 12, 15 are the smaller ones. 6 and 14 are the larger pieces. All right, so 14 is the top assembly. 14 goes in first, then 6. Lock it up. Then smaller side is 15. And then locks up with the 12. Okay. And now we, this little rubber bands, so no longer it goes at the top, there's two slots, and then the shorter one goes on the left hand side. Two slots. And just push them through the slots, and we're complete on the sub assembly there. Page 5. Moving on to page number 6. We need the long shaft on board number 1 on the left here. It's long and probably fragile, so be careful pushing it out. Need part number 6, we have it out already. And I think that's it for the step number 1. So part number 6, the rest is not needed. We wax it around, as always. Then we need to sand that longer side of the shaft. Just put a little bit of waxing on both sides. And let's see, we need a little piece of toothpick cut to size 2Z or Z2. It says Z2, but 2Z on the actual helping tool. And I think it was the piece. And I have found it. So with the that longer side tabs are on the right, we insert part number 6 all the way from the left hand side. And it goes all the way to the tabs here, past the hole. And then into the hole goes the little toothpick that we just pre-cut. And you insert it through so until it's symmetrical and holds the part down. From the same side, that's we're into step number 2, we need part number 18, 17, 17 at the top left here. We'll need 2 of those. So I'll push both out. And then part number 18 all the way at the top in the middle here. Part number 19. It's going to be a little bit below to the right. And then part number 17, which we just pulled out. So let's see. We need to wax both surfaces here. And part number 18. No, not wax, sorry. Sand. And then 17, we get clean it off the excess wood. Lubricate both of them. Now first 17 goes right onto that shaft from the left side, same thing. Let's see, with the little tabs or cutouts in a vertical direction, then we put number 18. So the way it goes is with there's furthest holes toward you, and that goes on the through the bottom hole. Then number 19 on the end, and I would clean it up a little bit the gears because there's a little bit of connection points. So take those out and put a little bit of wax on those onto the gears. Teeth that goes at the end there against the surface of number 18, and then it all locks up with the 17 again, just like that. The next step is we insert the sub-assembly that we just did. And remember I mentioned the waxing on the gears, which we already did, so we don't have to do this step right here. And let's see, so with the longer, we need to match the sides. So the 3 holes need to match these 3 parts there. So, and then you insert them snapping the parts in there, make sure they all fit into the holes, the cylindrical parts on there, all the way through, and all, here we go, as far as it can go, so they're going to be all held together, and then these 2, as you can see, are rotating in the right direction, so we're done with step number 3. So as I spin the rod, this one also spins because the gears are interconnected. So we put it step number 4. We need part number 14 and 20. So 14 is going to be 20 is on the right top right here. and a 14. Let's see. Gonna be on the bottom. We already used that once. So I'd put a little bit of wax on the number 14 on that cylinder. That goes all the way on the top rod. Then it can go only one way, and then 20 with the teeth facing towards the left goes over it. Next step is number 15 and 21. They're also on board number 1. 21 is on the right hand side, a little bit below all the open ones. And then we need number 15, which is on the bottom next to the 14, right at the center there. Same thing, I would wax it just in case, although it doesn't seem like it's going to be used, but just be on the safe side. 15, it goes on the one on the left. Let me see. On the left one, on that little rod with the holes. And there's a little marks, they should be in a horizontal position, so it goes on easy. And then number 21 with the teeth facing top right, we insert it through here and make sure that little rod, I guess, goes through the top hole. Just insert it like this until it locks up and these holes are sticking out. We're done with step number 5, moving on to page number 7. Now we need a little bit screwed up pictures here. Something wrong with the printing, that's right. So part number 22, two of them. They're on, let's see, about center line, a little above the middle, to the right of the center, vertical center. 222s. And then those go, first one goes into the open hole right here, right at the center. And second one goes in the open hole on the bottom left here, with the semicircular cutouts kind of facing to the top and bottom on both of them. And now we need 5 little 2Z2 toothpicks. So once again, take a toothpick, cut in half, flat portion, put it inside the tool. 1, 2, 3. We need 5 of them. And now they go into all, pretty much all the holes you see. So to lock all the assemblies in. And then there's 3 holes in that center one. There are 3 holes. Need to insert in all 3 of them. A little bit hard, because we have parts on the way, so I'm gonna rotate it a little bit and go from the horizontal direction, I guess. And those also need to be symmetrical. I plane, horizontal plane of that part. All right, 1, 2, 4. So with no 5. So this hole still stays empty. I guess that one's gonna be used a little bit later. All right, so all 4 are in there. I'm gonna put it aside right now. We're done with step number 2 all the way in the right. And then let's see, we need one to the size of 3Z. So the 3Z is a little longer. I have a one pre-cut toothpick here, so I'm gonna use that. I'm done with the 3Z. And then we need half of the toothpick. All right, so now part number 23 and part number 24. So there are 24s on the right here, a little above the center and or middle, horizontal middle, and then 23 is right around the center, almost all the way to the top. So we started with the 23 with that brown hole on the right. Well, half of the toothpick we inserted on the hole that is all the way to the left, all the way to the end, and then the 24 with the tabs facing away, the long toothpick we insert on the right hand side hole, and then 2Z or Z2, 2Z we insert on the left hole, not the 3Z. Use the tool to push it in. And now we need to apply a little bit of a sanding paper on that surface. And that's why I have the files. And now the 23 goes through the center hole on that tall toothpick down onto that sub-assembly. Now we need part number 25, which is also on board number 1 on the right hand side here. We put the 3Z through that hole and we make it symmetrical. There's number 7 in there. And I put a wax on the teeth of that gear. Just shows right there in the step, in between step number 4 and number 5. And then let's see, 25 goes on the site, or actually goes into that hole right here, like a little slot. And then we need parts number 26 and 27, which is also gears. 26 is the smaller gear right here, and then 27 is right next to it. Same thing, apply wax to the teeth. And then the gear with the part number or number 6 goes in the center toothpick or the one on the right. And then the smaller gear, which has number 5 on it, goes on the left toothpick. All right, we're done with page number 7. Moving on to page number 8. And then that's a sub-assembly. With the tabs facing you, turn it around. We take that long or rod sticking towards the top. We insert that sub-assembly. So there's slots here, so the center toothpick or toothpick on the left goes through that center hole, and the toothpick on the right goes through that slot, and the little number 7 toothpick goes into the slot on the left hand side, and it goes in. through all the way. So we need to wiggle a little bit with 5, as it needs to go past the opening there. There you go. And number 7 is falling out, the gear number 7, I mean. There you go. All the toothpicks could get it got into the place. Make sure you flatten them out on one side there. And it's everything is pushed towards the gears there. Let's see, I don't want to mess it up right now. It doesn't show any movement. So now we cut out the center toothpick here, the one that goes through the smaller hole. Just pre-cut it a little bit and snap it off, because we don't need it at this point of time. That's step number 2. Step number 3, we take part number 28. Also on board number 1. Just need to find it. It's gonna be part number 28. Towards the top here on the left hand side between number 6 and number 7. And that goes over the toothpick that is sticking out still. All the way to the surface. And we cut off the toothpick. Step number 4. So pre-cut and snap it off. Alrighty, so we put that on a side for now. Step number 5. Need parts number 12, 17, 30, 31, and 17 again. So part number 29 is on the left here. Where's my helping tool? It's a long piece. And kind of with a lot of steps. Part number 17 is right next to it. Both of them we can pull out. Part number 30 is a little below, right at the kind of like in between the center line and the edge. And then part number 17 we have, and one of the 31. So 31 is right, the gears right to the right of part number 29, below, like a lower end of 29. All right, so here part number 17, clean off of the extra material fibers, put a little bit of wax on it, on both of them. Then gear number 31, wax on the teeth, and then we take part number 30 and send it. Literally, you don't need to send too much, just a couple movements of your hand. Now with it, part number 29 with the shorter piece facing towards the top, we push number 17 through the bottom portion with the cutouts on the horizontal plane. And that doesn't go very easy. So I'm gonna remove it. Use a little bit of a sandpaper. Send down the connection points there. And maybe apply a little bit of wax on the surface. And now it should slide on much easier. Using my nails a little bit. Then part number 30 with the square towards yourself, square cut out through that hole. Then part number 31, the gear. Also all the way to the end. And then we lock it with another part number 17. Should have a little bit of a movement. And we're done with that sub-assembly, put it on the site. Step number 6, we need part number 32. which is on the left next to the 30. Port number 33, right above it. Port number 34 to the right of port number 29 that we had. And then we need to cut one toothpick to the size of 3Z. Top toothpick. Doesn't cut very easy. So with a semicircle cut out, we'll wax the front surface there. Part number 33 with this slot going in the horizontal direction, we insert it into the square cutout there, opening all the way to the end. 3Z goes 34, we need to wax. Through the hole first and then 34. That would be easier. All the way to the edge, then 34 goes on top. And that little sub-assembly that we just made with part number 29 towards you. That goes, there's a hole, that's the where the toothpick goes through, and then number 17 goes into the slot. Make sure the gears match up. Push the toothpick out, there you go. So it's sitting both on there, and then when you rotate the 29, it should rotate both of the gears. And then we're done with step number 7 on page number 8. And then that assembly goes with the cutout towards the top, rod on the bottom, and we insert the 29 into that little square hole on the smaller part, just like this. Now we need part number 6. There's another set of 4 of them. Push them out. Don't forget to wax it a little. That goes onto the center portion here, up to the next toothpick, just like that. And now we need in step number 2, part number 35, that's a larger part right there in the center of board number 1. With a longer side facing towards the top, we need to sand this surface. I'll sand both surfaces just to be on the safe side. And then that goes kind of like inside, in between the little sub-assembly that we just inserted, onto the rod. Let's see, with a holes on the left side with that circular cutout on the right, because I started inserting the wrong way, and then it snaps onto the those little tabs that are sticking out. And let's see, it goes up to the holes, but the rods are in there, but not going through the holes. And that's, we're done with that step number 2 on the right hand side circle there. Now we need part number 6 and 36. Let's see, port number 6. We just had it, 1036, that's the on the right hand side. Little cylindrical portion here. We'll take port number 6 out. As always, clean it off and put a little bit of wax on the outer surface. And then 6 goes over that rod in the center one, the smaller one, and then 36 right over it. Now we need, I'll put a little bit of wax right on around there. And now we need parts number 37. So parts number 37 are on the right. Right in the middle. And we need to use the tool to push them out. There's 6 little cylinders. Now, these are tough little guys because we need to, these are gonna be our bearing cylinders. So what we need to do here is sand the connection points so there's no interference there, because those connection points will create some friction. And then we also apply wax to it. On the outer surface of the cylinders. Also need to pre-cut 2Z just to make sure that we have it ready. To the size to to insert those 37s into the gears. So make sure with the flat surface are going towards the center, kind of like normal to the towards the center. So we just put those cylinders in, and I forgot to take out port number 38 to wipe them all down to make sure they don't fall out. Try to put it the wrong way. And port number 38 is in the middle here on the right. So that one we insert over, locking those up, and then 2Z into the hole, locking that port number 38 in place, and all right, I don't like it that way, so I'm gonna take one of the toothpicks, push it through, it's another way to do it. So it's sticking out on one side. And then I'm going to pre-cut it. And on the other side. Snip it off. Kind of creating a 2Z right on the spot rather than pre-cutting it, because it was hard to insert into the hole. So now rotating that rod, that should move. We got that. And we're moving on to the page number 10. Page number 10, we need the two large rubber bands. Those go through these two openings that are we created, that I almost forgot to. So you just bend the rubber band and kind of like slide it through, or try to. For some reason, I'm always trying to pull away from the view. Kind of like halfway, and we're doing the same thing on the other side. Now we need part number 39. Which is in the middle, center. Board number one, and we take that, we insert the rubber band both sides, top and bottom. To the slots, top and then bottom, just like that. And then we need part number 40, which is on the bottom right here with the long sticks on both sides. Take 46 out from the center, just put it aside for now. Then we need part number 2. It's on the board number 1 towards the bottom there. And then part number 3, which is right next to it. Now with the that part 39 facing towards you, make sure all the rubber bands are on it. We push 40 through it with the that O'Brien's cut out on the right hand side. We push the part number 39 through, holding the rubber bands, make sure they don't fall out. Now we take number 2, make sure the teeth are facing clockwise direction again, so which is going to be opposite from the other part that we have on the inside there. Push it on. Kind of like in a similar fashion as the other one, we just insert the little tabs on the right hand side. Into the gear, and then we'll lock it up with part number 3, which I will also wax. And then, put a little bit of a sand to part number 40 around here where the gear will be. Sandpaper. And let's see, now we need to insert part number 41 and 17. So 17 on right hand two on the top here. Stick one up. Part number 41. It's gonna be on the right hand side below the middle here next to 43. So 41 would be first with the slot going horizontal direction. And then part number 17, put a wax on the outside surface of the cylinder. And then with the slots also in a horizontal direction, put it over part number 41. Clean it up. There's a little bit of excess material there, so I'm gonna just snap it off a little bit with my box cutter or X-Acto knife. And let's see, step. Need a little rubber band, got to about 15 millimeter loop. Try to remake it. All right, so about 15 millimeters. Part number 42, which is also on the same board, right in the middle here. Alrighty, so that loop, rubber band goes through that smaller hole. Goes over the part number 17 that we just put. Let's do rubber band. We snap it on these little two hooks or double hook on the left hand side of part number 40, holding the other side of the rubber band. Loop it around, bend it over and snap the other side on it. Like that, and then we can put that part. Let's see. Correct, so it's not supposed to go through that loop. And then we put it over, stretch that rubber band a little bit, and put number 42 over that part number 17. Just like that. So it's going to be locking that gear up. And we're done with page number 10. Moving on to page number 11. Now we need part number 43, which is next to the 40 on board number one. And then with that slot, same slot facing to the left, we put it over, kind of locking that sub-assembly up that we just did. Just like that. I would take it apart for a sec and sand it. Just apply a few rounds of sandpaper there. Onto that part. Now we need parts number 44, two of them. They're in the middle, a little bit to the left here. Part number 45, the big gear to the bottom of it. And part number 6, we already have it obviously applying the wax onto the large gear. Wax onto number 6. 44 goes into the two openings with the slot being horizontal axis. Sticking out of there, so make sure that it's flat on both sides here and there on the back so it doesn't fall out. Let's see, and what's next? Part number 6 over the gear number 45 that we put in first. And then port number 6 to lock it up. And then we have part number 46 that we removed a little bit earlier. That goes through that to release a little bit back. That I accomplished by pulling that little sub-assembly that we just inserted with the rubber band. Now we need to lock it with port number 46, so it needs to go all the way to the end. There's exclamation point, so it has to sit all the way in. Now we put that aside. Sub-assembly goes step number 4. We need rod number 47 on the bottom left to the right of 97, so it's a smaller one on the left hand side of board number 1. That one's a little bit harder to pull out, so I'm gonna pre-cut the little connection points here to make sure we don't damage it. Now it falls out very easy. And we need parts number 48, 17. Have one more 17 here on the top. Another 17 here on the right hand side. Just need one more. There you go. And number 15, bottom center line. Alrighty, and so we apply to all the little cylinders, we apply wax. We apply wax to the gear. Number 47, we get a gear, and number 17, one of the 17s, over it. And then on the other side, we do number 15 and then number 17 to lock it up also. going to use the tool to move it all the way in. All right. Part of it fell out, but should be okay still. Let me clean it up a little bit. It didn't break in half, did it? Disintegrated, and let's see, we do have extra port 17. So I'm gonna take that one off, the one that broke. And I'm gonna use one more from board number one. We'll find the spare one later when we need it. So same thing, just wax it. And because that one was going very bad, I would wax the rod a little bit too. Just to make sure that it goes all the way in. Alrighty. Now we need part number 49, which is on board number 3. And it's one large on the side here. Is going on the right. Make sure it says L, which is left side. Then there is a little opening on the left side here. Wax it a little bit around it, and then that's where the side with the gear goes in. We're done with page number 11. Then moving on to the page number 12. Insert the full sub-assembly that we just did with the rods going towards the right hand side and kind of like on the bottom. That goes into the, let's see, so that little rod that we just put, it should go in between opening here somehow, little towards the top. Squeeze it in. Then it should go only one way into that side. Make sure everything squeezed in all the way to the end. So your rod comes out right next to that rubber band right here, the one that we just put, and then number 40 gonna rotate it a little bit. At the with the top portion goes through the opening here, slides through, and then everything else gets locked in. Just like that. So we're done on the side here. Now we need a little bit part toothpick size number 2Z. Into the little opening here. We're sticking out on the side panel. problem is to get it in, and then once you start it, you can use the tool to get it through. Then you just need to make sure that it sticks out a little bit on both sides to lock the assembly in place so it doesn't fall out. So we're done with that. Now we need part number 50, which is also on board number one on the right hand side here on the bottom. And that one wax or sand. It was on both sides with the little cutouts towards you that goes into the two slots that are second row. Push it all the way in. Now parts number 51, 52, and 17. So we use one more 17. Is on the center line bottom here, and 51 is on the right. On the right here, and we need to wax number 52 and 17. Already should be waxed, but just in case, put a little bit more wax on that. So 52 goes onto the rod, then 51 goes onto the rod, 52 goes all the way at the end here . Try it both ways, whichever way is easier for it to go on all the way to the tip. Make sure you don't break the rod. Here we go. And then number 17 is right after it to lock it up. All right, and we're done with page number 12. All right, and we need parts number 53, 54, and 55. They're on the right hand side here. There's six of them total. So two sets of each. So 53, 54, 55, and these are from the left. Doesn't show the mirror image, so we should be good. We need four toothpicks cut in half. Total, get eight pieces then. Recording, so we're good. And so on the left hand side we have 53. We need to make sure that all the errors match. 54 and 55 on top. The 55's got like a little lug drawing, and 53 is square connections rather than circular. So we just push the toothpicks through the all four holes there and there. First one, and then get all the toothpicks in there. I'm going to use my helping tool. Easier. So I push it all the way in. If it breaks, that's okay because I have enough length in there to stick the other two parts on there. And then the last one, I'm just gonna push it against the table. Then once again, make sure that your errors match. So a number 54. On the third part, I didn't say the errors should match, and I inserted incorrectly. It was noticed right away because your holes are offset because of that. So, and once again, the lug nuts should be on top. Like this, and then you just break out these toothpicks and you can take them off. And then we do the same thing on the other side. So 53 we start with. Doing the same thing here, just pushing the toothpicks all the way in. Until they're flat to the table, then number 54 and 55. So as you can see, I'm applying pressure right away on all four sides, so to say, or both ends at the same time to make sure it doesn't break. So then, just push it all the way in, snap off the toothpicks, pre-cut and snap. And we're done. Now we need part number 56 and two parts number 12. 56 is on the board number 2 all the way on the left here. 12s would be at the top, a little bit to the left of the center line. There are two number 12s in there. Just use your helping tool there to push those out. Should be good to go. Now, once again, it's a cylindrical part. I know it's not a gear, but just in case, I'm gonna put a little bit of a wax on the outside of them. To wax, I'm gonna use the stick. Let's see, on inside of the rod. The stick's so the flat surface is there. See, we need parts number 50. Okay, so number 12's on there. Put them on both sides, all the way to the end. And then we need parts number 57 and 58, 8 of them. So there's a block on that number 2 board with all 8 parts. I'm gonna pull it all out. So 57s, 857s, let's see, 858s. throw out not needed pieces. Let's see, and we need two wags on the inside of both. Kind of like a little hook portion. So that's where my wags here comes in into play. All the parts, and now 57 should be waxed on the inside, and I'm just dipping it in a little bit into the wax, which makes the assembly a little easier, I hope. All the parts are waxed, so we go on to the assembly them onto the rod, and we start, doesn't matter for which, with which one, but seven or 58, and then you slide one into another. Like that, so you just slide in, and let's see, so it's gonna be 1, 2, 3, 4, two on each small section there. Be careful, it slide one into another and they lock together. And you just continue with all eight. Thought they slide through the side, but now you just push one against another and they should lock in place. Access wax if you got a little extra on there. All right, two more. Same thing, same exercise for all eight of them. You just push one into another and they should snap right into place. There we go. We got all eight, and now we need parts number 59, which are also on board number 2, about a little bit above the middle, horizontal middle, to the left of the vertical center line. And I'm just going to use my tool, careful not to break those. They got small necks. And they're kind of falling into my hands. So now the rod, one should face one direction, and the little holders there for the pistons, and the other one's the other direction, and they need to be, let's see. So the first one to the left, second one to the right. And then the way we put them on, we need to put a little bit of wax on the edges and on a round piece there. On all eight of them. So I'm just gonna apply dark surface, you apply the wax. If you want your model to operate good, make sure you do your wax application on all the parts that are mentioned in the manual. Emitting some might actually prevent from the whole assembly operating properly. Done of the wax, so I'm gonna take the shaft there, rod, and start with the first one. So I kind of just insert it from the side. Into the slots. It's all gonna stay together. And all of them are in, one is out. I'm just gonna kinda put it on the side here. Here we go. I'm gonna put them all on the side to make sure they don't fall out. And then we need to lock those up with part number 60. One side and on the other. So the 60 is right in the middle here, like right at right at the center line, right above the middle on the board number 2. And let's see, and we go first one to the left and we insert it to lock the little piston in place. See if I got it right. I'm gonna switch the page a little bit. Let's see, where does it go? So it's kind of like at the line. No, it doesn't fit in the line where it's locking. So you just need to aim it towards the center of the piston rod. All right, so first one to the left, second one to the right. Put the piston back in if it fell out. Use that number 60 and lock it in. They're not facing the same side. I think I'm doing it correctly. Guess we'll see it in a little bit. Obviously, this is my interpretation of the manual. I have not assembled. This is my first time assembling the model, just like you guys. Alright, so part number 60 goes towards the center of that circular portion, cylindrical circular portion of the rod. Make sure all the rods are in place and make sure that you do kind of like in a checker sequence, so every other one facing different direction. Let's see. write those down. Move on to the page number 14. I did already the step number one. Now step number two is that we take the piston assembly or piston shaft assembly that is closest to you and facing to the left. That's where the left side goes on with the arrow facing away from you. So you just insert those rods through the holes in the block. And push it in, and then the other side, the block, the arrow facing on the right side facing towards you, and then you insert the other four rods. Just like this. All the way down. Alright, and now we need part number 61, also board number 2, and they're right about halfway from middle towards the top on the left hand side. And because those are the pistons, we need to wax a little, these little cylinders on the outside. Alright, I'm just making sure that it's all clean and peeling off any extra material that are that is on them. Just apply wax on the outer surface. Up and down easy inside the block. Alrighty, and now we just apply them, let's see, the little cutouts in the perpendicular to the length of the rod. Is that the right way? Looks like it is. And you just see them, sit them on there flush with the piston rod. And kind of push back a little bit so it gets inside the head or inside the block. And same thing on the other side. So now if you move the cylinders more into V, or the engine, you should have two of them sticking out more than the other. Let's see. Now we need part number 62, which is on same board number 2 at the top here, and then 63 and 64, they're right below to the left. 64 doesn't have any holes on here. 63's got two additional. And I take number 62 with the cylinders facing down. And the tab that is a little bit higher up on the right hand side. And then 63 goes on the left into the hole, kind of like a little open slot here. And then 64 goes into the slot right here on that little tab on the right hand side. Now that goes with the arrow on the right hand side still. The center camshaft goes into the center hole here. And the heads go on these little tabs that are sticking out. Gonna need to get them on there correctly. And push them in. Let's see, make sure that you have clearance in there too, so it goes slides in rather than just being stuck. Side and the other side. Can't put it down either to apply the pressure. Helps a little bit, so you don't have to press on that little pointy thing. You just push the tool against it and push it down. Let's see, one side, get it down flat to the surface. All right, and there you go, on all the sides. It's all on the number 62. And let's see. Oh, I should have applied a little bit of wax on there, but would have snapped much easier. But we'll do it on the other side. And there it's we need part number 65. Holes on board number 2 on the right hand side, a little bit above the middle. And then the DC facing out in the right direction. So same thing, just adjust the tabs, make sure they fit in nice in there in the corresponding holes. Challenge to get them all aligned. Here you go. We got the alignment now. Everything is in proper location. And now just squeeze these together. Make sure your camshaft gets in there too correctly. obviously your plugs and all the tabs. Make sure they're fully inserted. Sides. Now we got our little engine, which I can't turn yet because these little things are too small. But we're done with step number 6 on page number 14. Moving on to the next page, number 15. And here it's, let's see. Step number 1 is to remove all the parts number 60 from the assembly. I guess they're not needed after all. Kinda a little tough to stick the fingers in there. Those are just parts to secure the pistons in one place so they don't fall out during the assembly. So all the parts, I think it was number 60, all of them get removed. You can use your helping tool a little bit too. Move it up and down to get it off. All right. Now, looks much easier. At least I can make one full revolution. All right. Step number 2, let me make sure we're still recording and we're all good. Step number 2 is part number 66 and 67, also on board number 2 on the bottom left here is the 66, it says V muscle on here. And then the part number 67 is right below it in the corner. So here I need the tool to pull it out, push it out. And now it goes right in the center of the V muscle. Make sure it's facing the top. And just like shown on the picture, the direction of that 67 goes in there flat to the bottom surface. And now 68 is on the top, which is also next to 67 bottom left here, with the flat portions in a long direction. So it doesn't cover the V muscle, goes on top. I'm assuming it's a carburetor. And then that goes on top of the assembly with the part number, I think it was 65. Yeah, 65 facing to the right, V muscle towards you, towards V muscle facing you. And that goes on to these little tabs right here. Sides and you're good to go. That's step number 4. The next step is if you can make sure that the cylinders move. If not, then we can check it later at a later point of time. Now we need 2 toothpicks cut to the size to the length of 2Z. Part 69, which are also on board number 2, and they're towards the top here, the only two little things that are left on the right hand side next to number 70. which we also will need to pull out. Just in, we'll use it in a second. And step number 6. Insert these little toothpicks into number 69. To get them in. A little tough because the parts are small, toothpicks are tiny. Get them in, they should go in, and you get one edge flat with the surface. Alright, now these go on the right hand side on the part number 65. There's two holes on there, so you push those through the holes, and if your toothpick pops out a little, just use your helping tool to push it in. So it's flat with the surface of that cylinder 69. And then part number 70, it's a, looks like a fan that goes onto the camshaft. Just like this. Now you can check, make sure your cylinders work. And we turn it around, and then part number 71, which is right in the center line here, additional part number 61. I'm gonna put it aside. And then that gear has part number 10 on there, so we make sure you wax the gears. And also back surface of that gear and or the surface of the engine block. Over and just make sure everything rotates properly. So we're done with page number 15. Moving on to page number 16. We turn it upside down. As I mentioned, easy movement there. That's what we're checking for. And then to part number 72. That's step number 8 on page 16. And these 72s are right in the middle, a little above middle. Up in the right of the center line. I guess I'm gonna use these definitions. And then with that wiggle thing going towards the right, and you insert it into these little holes on the parts closest to you. And on the furthest one. Step number 8 on page number 16. Moving out a little bit to the right, it's going to be building our suspension. Okay, so let's continue. Page 16, right here to the right, step number 1, we need parts number 73, 74, and 75. That should be on board number 3. So let's see. 75s are right here, now right at the about center. So just push them out. Part number 73 is middle of the board, and then part number 3 is centered a little bit to the left, closer halfway between the middle and the bottom. So I'll just pull that part out. Let's see, using helping tool. Number 73 and part number 74 should be two of them right a little bit above and to the left of 75. let's see, we need to put a little bit of a wax on 73. You can use the, once again, you can use either the stick that is provided, or you can use one of your own candles. And then 74, we need outside diameter to be waxed. And so we need to assemble two of these. That 73 goes through 74. So you need to put a little bit of a sanding on here and then 73, just to make sure that 74 goes on fine. You can use either sandpaper provided, or you can use one of your own little files. And then 74 has to go all the way up to the top there. And then through 75. Into 75. Same here, so if you see the little slots there, they're going to be on the site, on the solid surfaces, while the hole is facing you. All the way down. And then a port, and then port number 76, which is also located on board number 3, a little bit to the left of the center line at the top there. Way you put it, it's just the 73 goes right into these slots. On both sides. Push them as far as they can go. And then we need two ports number 77. They're also on board number 3 to the right of the center line, all the way at the edge there, two of them. And then they go, if you hold that sub-assembly that we just completed, same way as shown on the picture, 77 with that long extension arm, one goes on the right side and the other one goes facing left. So then you push it all the way down as far as they can go. Now we need four little toothpicks with the help of the helping tool. We need to put the toothpicks on the side there, my X-Acto knife. So just split it in half. And then as it's inserted, we need two Z's, we need four of those. One. Three and one more. Four. Alrighty. And then those go into this second hole that is closer to the parts there. Part number 77 there. No, not 77, I apologize. That's going to be on 75. Probably should incorporate tweezers here to hold these toothpicks. I prefer the old way that they used to do the toothpicks, where you insert and then you just cut a little, but either way should work. And just these ones a little harder to insert. So insert it like symmetrical on, sticks out about the same distance on both sides. That's just to hold the parts in place that they don't fall out. So you need two of here, and then you turn it upside down, that sub-assembly, and you put two toothpicks into these little holes through port number 73. Alrighty, and that would complete our step number 5 on page 16. Moving to page number 17. Let's see, step number 6. We need a toothpick cut to size 3Z, two of them. So 3Zs, and then 4Z, we're gonna make also two of them. That's the longer. Toothpicks ready. Step number 6, we need part number 78, which is on board number 3 also, right in the middle here. So this is a pretty, looks like fragile part. So what you do, you take the X-Acto knife, you find a little connection points, which is like white marks, then you just pre-cut it, or cut them off there, make sure you get into the slot, and then after you do that, the part will just fall out. So it's a fragile piece. If you're gonna try to do it by pushing by your hand, there's a chance that you might break it. But no worries, we can replace the parts if you purchase from me, no charge. And then if elsewhere, there's a small $350 shipping fee. Let's see, and then part number 69, there's two of them that we need right now. They're right to the right of the center line, halfway between middle and the top of the board. And we use 3Z shorter toothpicks. They go through the hole to 69. I'll use the little helper tool just to push it all the way to the edge. Then I almost lost 169. It fell down on my knees, but either that or you can push it down until you hit the edge there, and then through number 78, and then they go into the part number 75. These little extension facing up into that second hole that was left open. Alrighty, now we got a little control arm there. Now step number 7, we need parts number 12. 1, 2, 3, 4, 8, and two number 15s. They're all should be on the same board number 3, so 12, four of them right here, right in the middle, and then another 4 is right at the top right edge. So you can either push the rectangle out or square, or the parts out, it doesn't matter, just make sure you keep them all together and you know where they're at. And then part number 15, just right below the middle here, we need two of them right now. And then two more in the next step, but we'll use the two first. Now, I'd say get all the 12s out. Clean them up, make sure there is no extra wood left there in the slots. I'm just checking if we're still recording, we're good. Gotta do periodic checks just to make sure that power's up to the phone. Alrighty, and then I'd recommend, although it shows only four number 12s need to be waxed, but I would wax all of them because there's a chance that all of them's gonna go. Oh, no, it shows a further down to wax all of them, so might as well just do the job right away instead of waiting until they're installed, which might be a little bit harder to get to at that point of time. So anything, cylinders, you're safe to almost wax all of them. Alrighty. And I'll do number 15s also. Alright, so number 15s go on the side here, all the way to the edge, and then number 12s right behind it. If they go pretty tight, I'd recommend to put a little bit of the sandpaper or file to get it sanded down. If you have trouble pushing it all the way down to the edge or to the base there, I guess. And two 12s goes on each of these posts with a hole, two holes actually, I guess, or slot in the hole. And once again, those go all the way down to the base. Slots are on the same side as the holes. Looks like those cutouts are rectangular, so that's probably the only way that it's gonna go in. Alrighty, and then we're up to step number 8. We need part number 79, which is also right in the middle there of board 3 to the left. And the board's becoming flimsy. Alright, and then 215s, or one right next to the other 215s. Now wax those two. So let's see, with the part 78 facing towards you, the thinner piece, part number 79 with the this extension, I guess, facing towards you also. Just put it over the little number 12 that we just put in, and then lock it up with the number 15. And then 4Z pre-cut toothpicks goes into that bottom hole on both sides. And then you push it through. So it is about symmetrical around that cylinder. Sticking out. Alright, that one didn't work very well. And we need to push it out, so I'll just use another toothpick from the opposite side. And we need to cut another 4Z, because that one broke. Alrighty. Alright, symmetrical above the cylinders, so the toothpick sticks out about the same distance on both sides. And now we need two rubber bands to about 20 millimeters. So as you remember, just loop it around your finger. Oops. And through. It seems like taken too long of a break and I forgot how to do it. So create a loop and then you adjust it to the length that you need as you tie that loop. There you go. About right. And then we'll make on both sides, just work on a one rubber band. Another loop on the other side. About 20 millimeters. So now we got two loops on one rubber band, and now it's just cut them, and you got two parts that you need. And now the rubber band goes right into these little slots over the toothpicks. Push it in through the toothpicks, through that hole in the top, in between the toothpicks, and then into the slots on the other side. And as you stretch the toothpicks, it's actually easier to put it in when it's stretched. And then it slides right in. Kinda. So I'll just stretch it. And I'll use the tool to push it into that little slot. Oop, not even making the slot. That's why I couldn't put it in. One more try. Side. One is in. looks like they're in. Just need to hold that end. Here we go. And now they're in. The tooth, let's see, the rubber band should stretch out by itself a little bit. And we do the same thing on the other side. And we should there. Around rubber band, I mean around toothpick. Through the hole, around the toothpick, and then into the other two slots. And as I stretch it, I push it a little, and then... sticks out, but it should release by itself slowly. Let's see if I can push it out a little bit just to get it. Sitting against the surface. Get it relaxed a little bit on both sides. There. We're done with step number 10 on page number 17. Moving to the next page number 18. Then we installed all that sub-assembly onto the engine block that we created. So there is these two little tabs. They go into these two holes right at the engine block. So I kind of push it through and then you push it in to lock it onto the engine. There you go. Make sure the engine still rotates. Yep, everything good. Cylinders move. We're all good. Completed step number 11 on page 18. Moving to the right, step number 1, page 18. Once again, board number 3. We've got on the right hand side, there is a long piece number 80 right here, right in the middle. Push that out, and now we need two Z's, three of them. Let's see. Two Z toothpick. And we need one more. These are too short. They go into the port number 80, so there's a letter L, so face down, and then it goes into these two bottom holes for the toothpicks. Once again, it's very painful to press on the toothpick, so I just use the tool to press it down against the surface of the table. Just need to make sure that you get the toothpick into the hole and then use the tool to push it down. And then we put a toothpick one on the right above the toothpick that we just inserted. So add a little hole, push it all the way down. And then we need part number 81, also on board number 3. It's right below the 80. It's a little grill. And then that one gets inserted with that little tab on the right hand side, right over those toothpicks. Make sure you match the holes, two bottom ones to the bottom, and then top one on the right to the top. Alrighty, and then step number three, we need three Z's. We need two of those. So I forgot the toothpicks. Go through that third or fourth open hole, push it all the way down, and then the hole closest to that grill that we just installed on the right hand side. And then you push it all the way through. So it sticks out on the other side. It's flat with the surface on one side, flat on the surface, and sticks out on the back where letter L is. And here we've got part number 83, which is also on board number 3, top right here. Long and fragile parts, so remember to pre-cut it, otherwise you may break. Three places there, use the tool, push it out, it should fall out almost immediately. And then we need part number 69, there's one left in that little cluster. So 83, we're have that facing here with the little tab here facing towards the top. We put it under the toothpick on the left, all the way down to the base. And then 69 is to lock it up right over it, so it should move like this, up and down. There will be a little lever that holds the hood once you open it up. Let's see, and then we put that on the engine assembly. We're page number 19 on the left there, so it goes right into these little two tabs on the sub-assembly that we just recently installed, with the L facing towards the engine, so the grill is facing you. And we just, those go in the two top holes. Right in. We're done, put it aside. Page number 19 on the right hand side, step number one. We need a part number 84. It's on board number 5. And it's bottom left right here. Long piece. Let's see. Then we need two toothpicks to the length of 3Z. Go, so we need to wax that surface here, so hook on the left hand side, and we're just wax the entire surface on top. But there's a little connection point there, I'm gonna send it off and re-wax it. And now the toothpicks go through these two holes from the back. Surface. And now we need a little piece of rubber band. We got some leftovers from previous build. I'm just gonna gonna reuse it. And we need about 8 millimeters. So very short. That's why I was able to reuse one of the pieces there. And that goes through that little slot. I have no idea. I'll use the little toothpick just to push that. Make sure you go from, I guess, the front. So when the hook is on the left, the toothpick's facing towards the back. And then you push the rubber band through. I'm using the toothpick through that little hole. Sticks out enough for me to grab it on the other side. A little more. And once I grab it, I'm gonna stretch it out and hook it onto the two little, or in between there, and then you tie it up so it's hooked and facing you towards the front. Now we need part number 85, which is that long piece on board number 3 that's been falling out. And then you take that extra part out. It does say letter R on there, so make sure that's the one that you use. So letter R facing you, that long piece, that's step number 2, we insert through the little slot, two slots here. So the one, both toothpicks go into that long slot with the hook facing towards the left. And put a little bit of a sanding on the side, on the surface, because it's going to be sliding back and forth. And I put a little bit of wax there too. So the toothpicks go here into that slot. Make sure it moves back and forth. And then you put part number 86 on the back. Those are on board number 5 on the bottom there, bottom left corner, all the way in the corner, so easy to locate. Use a little tool to push them out. Those would lock the toothpick on this side. So that will keep that. And make sure there is movement, not much, but just a little bit back and forth. Now we need to stretch that rubber band that we just made. Push the sub-assembly all the way back. We're in these little 1, 2, 3 steps. Stretch it, and then we need to insert through that little hole there. Let's see if we can grab it. It through, probably with a toothpick is better, so you can grab it on the other side and snap it onto the, so I grabbed it by the nut. I'm gonna try to grab it by the nut. not as easy as it looks on the manual. So I push the toothpick through in between, then kind of trying to grab it to stretch out a little more. There you go. So, and then there's two slots there. One side of the rubber band goes into one slot and the other one's in the other one, and then I pull the toothpick out and it's good to go. Now we need to make sure that it moves back and forth. Give it a little play. So it should rubber band should bring that assembly back a little bit, so there's not enough wax there. So I would play a little bit back and forth. As we did put a little bit of a wax and sanding on there, though I guess we were supposed to put the, not on the top surface, but on the back surface of that little alright, here we go. I think it worked itself in, so it does push it back. So if you play with it a little bit, it's gonna eventually send itself off to the surface, so it pushes back on a rubber band. Just like this. Okay, we're done with page number 19. Moving on to the page number 20, step one. So we're gonna put that aside. Step one is gonna be part number 87. Actually, no, not on the side. We're still keeping it here. So we need another rubber band, about 5 millimeters, and part number 87, which is on board 5, right at the center line here. Toothpicks go. We need the following. One times one 2Z. That's the shorter one. And times two 3Z. Number 87 with a thicker portion towards the back and that little tab towards the top. We put two 3Zs into these little holes on the right, and then a 2Z is going to go in the hole to the left a little bit of those two. Let's again push them all the way down to the surface of the table. And now we need a little bit of a rubber band, about 5 millimeters. Very tiny one. So that, let's see, we're looking at same part that we, that long piece, what is it, number 85, all the way on the right there is two little tabs, so our little hood opener thing on the left here. We push the rubber band through this little opening right here. From the back. And hook it up into this little tab. Now we push it or stretch it out towards the back there from the front side, and then from the same side we put that sub-assembly there we just created, part number 87, into the two slots. The two long toothpicks go into the longer slot, and one small one into the short slot here. But what I would do is that I take that rubber band and I put it onto the part number 87, so it's already on there, and then I insert it into the toothpicks, which makes it much easier. And then we need to lock it up with part number 88. So I lay it down, make sure it doesn't snap off, and part number 88 is right next to 87, right at the center there, right below the middle, on board number 5. And with that one hooked towards the top, I guess that's the trunk release, and then you put it onto the two toothpicks, the three Z's, coming out from port number 87. Insert it all the way through, and then that should move back and forth also. We probably should have put some, a little bit of the wax on there on both sides. Yeah, probably do that. So I'm gonna take off that port 87, kind of pull it off a little bit. And add wax on both sides. Should move a little bit easier. And it should pull it back just like this. Work it back and forth a little bit so it adjusts to itself. Toothpicks further in. And we got our sub-assembly ready. That's on page number 20. All right, moving on to page number 21.